Members, the Senate is now in session. The work of the Budget and Health Committees having been concluded, we return to our business on the daily file. Senator Steinberg, under governor's appointments.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'd like to take up the confirmation of Arthur L. Anderson as a member of the Board of Parole Hearings.
Please proceed, Senator.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Mr. Anderson was approved by the Rules Committee on a vote of 5-0. He is one of 5 appointees to the board that were pending confirmation when we turned our attention to the budget. And he is the only one, I repeat, the only one I'm prepared to recommend to the Senate for approval at this time. In considering appointees to the parole board, we have to consider whether commissioners can be fair and objective, observe proper procedure, and act consistent with law and public safety. Right now, I believe that only Mr. Anderson has demonstrated that he meets these criteria, which is why he is being taken up. He was an administrator for the California Highway Patrol prior to his appointment. We are taking a hard look at the remaining commissioners, particularly as it relates to procedures and following the law. And if they are not up to the task, I will not recommend them to the Senate. I ask for your aye vote on Mr. Anderson. Thank you.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Secretary, call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? Aye. Blakeslee? Aye. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? Aye. Corbett? Aye. Correa? Aye. De Leon? Aye. Desaunier? Dutton? Aye. Emerson? Aye. Evans? Fuller? Aye. Gaines? Hancock? Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? Aye. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Carol Lieu? Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Price? Aye. Rubio? Runner? Rubio? Rubio? Aye. Runner? Aye. Smidian? Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland? Aye. Vargas? Aye. Walters? Wolk? Aye. Wright? Weiland? Aye. Yee? Yee? Aye. Desaunier? Aye.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Evans? Aye. Anderson? Gaines? Aye. Hancock? Harmon? LaMalfa? Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Pavley? Walters? Wright? Wright? Aye.
Call the absent members.
Anderson? Hancock? Harmon? LaMalfa? Carol Lieu? Pavley? Walters?
Senator Steinberg? We could either close the roll or place the measure on call for absent members. One last time, call the absent members.
Anderson, Hancock, Harmon, LaMalfa, LaMalfa aye, Carol Lieu, Pavley, Walters. Walters aye.
Ayes 35, noes 0. The governor's appointment is approved. Members, we turn now to the Assembly third reading file. Could I have the attention of the body for a moment, please, on Assembly third reading? Members, on Assembly third reading, we will begin working the file beginning at file item 31, and we will make our way through the file in consecutive order. We will attempt to move briskly, so if you can be ready when your bills are called and taken up, that will help us move the business of the day. We have more than 60 bills that the desk tells me are, in fact, eligible for today. File item 31, Do we have a floor manager? File item 32, Senator Leno, not at his desk. File item 33, Senator Hancock. Pass. File item 34, Senator DeSaulnier. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 147 by Assemblymember Dickinson, an act relating to subdivisions.
Thank you, Mr. President. AB 147 by Assemblymember Dickinson expands existing eligible uses for transportation mitigation impact fees for transit, bicycle, and pedestrian facilities. Current law limits the use of these fees for the mitigation of traffic impacts to bridges and major thoroughfares. This expands it to transit, bicycle, and pedestrian facilities as well. I would ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson? Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella?
No.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
No.
De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaulnier?
Aye.
Dutton?
No.
Emerson?
No.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller? Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
No.
Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio?
Aye.
Runner?
No.
Sumedian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
No.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
No.
Wolk?
Aye.
Wright? Weiland?
Yee.
Weiland, no.
Yee. All the absent members.
Yee, aye. Anderson, no. Blakeslee?
No.
Fuller?
No.
Harmon?
Wright.
Wright, aye.
Ayes 30, excuse me, ayes 23, noes 16. The bill is passed. File item 35. Senator De Leon, are you prepared to take up this item? If so, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 80 by Assemblymember Fong, an act relating to elections.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, as well as members. Current law requires the presidential primary to occur on the first Tuesday in February and prohibits it from being consolidated with the statewide direct primary. Absent a change to this law, California will be required to have three separate elections, February, June, as well as the general election in the fall of November. This would be imposing a huge gargantuan cost on state and local governments at a time when our financial situation is in crisis. California moved up our presidential primary in 2008 in hopes of gaining more national influence on the election of presidential candidates, only to find out that 33 other states moved up their primaries as well. The national political parties have adopted rules to sanction states who hold a primary or caucus before March, and our existing date is out of compliance with these specific rules. What AB 80 does, colleagues, is it eliminates California's standalone presidential primary election and requires that it be consolidated with other statewide primary elections. As a result, AB 80 will save the state and local governments close to $100 million on avoided election costs, increase voter participation, and ensure that California's primary is held in accordance with the national party rules. This is a bill that has enjoyed bipartisan support across the board and has no opposition. Colleagues from both sides of the aisle, I respectfully ask for an aye vote.
Debate or discussion, Senator Dutton.
Yeah, Mr. President, members, I'm actually going to rise in support on this. However, back in March, we had actually recommended that we should consolidate with a March date, which would have given us the best of both worlds. However, we were criticized pretty heavily about that, and the fact of the matter was that it was mainly done with the idea of trying to, you know, save some money, as been pointed out with this bill. The problem with this bill, though, is that by not having it in March, the primary election for the presidential combined with our regular state election, once again, California will not have any real significance in the presidential election process. However, I am going to support this because it will save us a lot of money.
Further debate or discussion, Senator Strickland.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, I rise in opposition of this bill. As was stated before, 4 years ago, actually California did make a difference in nominating on the Democratic side, in their presidential primary. And I think it was smart for California, for once and for all, when we talk about presidential elections, that our issues are actually resonating when we talk about these national elections. Too many times, California's ignored, their issues are ignored. When we talk about the Central Valley, the water issues ignored. And when a presidential candidate, for example, in early primaries like Nevada and early primaries like Iowa, they have their issues resonate moving forward because they matter in presidential politics. And so I agree with the consolidation of saving the money, but I was hopeful that we would move to a March primary and keep it early for both sides, because I know your presidential primary is already done. President Barack Obama will be your nominee, but I would like Californians to have, on the Republican side of the aisle, at least some influence within that presidential primary. So for those reasons, I urge a no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator De Leon, you may close. Forgive me, Senator Ames.
I rise in opposition. You know, while this saves the state money, it's at the expense of democracy. While those other states did move theirs up, we were the big dog in that cycle, and we helped focus the national debate. We're not going to be able to focus the national debate if we pass this bill. I urge a no vote.
Is there further debate or discussion? Senator LaMalfa.
I rise in reluctant support of the bill. I, too, wish this had been a March primary instead of a June one, for the reasons stated earlier. I do think it's important that we consolidate costs for the state here, because every special election does cost about $90 million. So I'm glad we didn't have other special elections this year that didn't have merit. But in the long term, if we really want California to be in on it earlier, a March one would be a better way to go. We all know the reasons why we had three elections in 2008. It wasn't so much to have California be somehow relevant in the February. It would have been more relevant later. It indeed was about having a term limit question on the ballot so termed out legislators can hang around here longer. That's why we had three elections in 2008. So that's what history shows from that. And at least this is a partial cleanup of a three-election system that happened in 2008. So I'll reluctantly support today's bill.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator De Leon, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. President. I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is a bill where we're putting politics to the side. This will save our state $100 million at the state as well as local levels when we consolidate our elections, as opposed to having three major elections, again, February, June, as well as November in the fall. We have to be fiscally prudent with the taxpayer dollars, with the taxpayers of the state of California. Again, we will save $100 million from taxpayers with that. I respectfully ask my colleagues for an aye vote.
Do we really need to do this now and interrupt the third?
Daryl just asked.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Alquist. Aye. Anderson.
No.
No. Berryhill. Aye. Blakeslee.
Aye.
Calderon.
Aye.
Cannella. Corbett. Aye. Correa. Aye. De Leon. Aye. DeSaunier.
Aye.
Aye. Dutton.
Aye.
Emerson.
Aye.
Evans. Fuller.
Aye.
Gaines.
Aye.
Hancock.
Aye.
Harmon. Hernandez.
Aye.
Huff.
Aye.
Kehoe.
Aye.
LaMalfa.
Aye.
Leno.
Aye.
Ted Lieu.
Aye.
Carol Lieu.
Aye.
Lowenthal.
Aye.
Negrete McLeod.
Aye.
Padilla.
Aye.
Pavley.
Aye.
Price.
Aye.
Rubio.
Aye.
Runner.
Aye.
Simidian.
Aye.
Steinberg.
Aye.
Strickland.
No.
Vargas.
Aye.
Walters.
Aye.
Wolk.
Aye.
Wright.
Aye.
Weiland.
No.
Yee. Yee. Aye.
Call the absent members.
Cannella, Evans, Harmon.
Ayes 34, noes 3, the bill is passed. Senator Leno, for what purpose do you rise?
Mr. President, to present AB 110.
Is there a file item number on this? File item 178. Members, we're stepping out of order for a moment because this measure needs to be sent over to the Assembly on a timely basis. We will return to our place on file in just a moment. Senator Leno, one moment, please. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 110 by Assemblymember Blumenfeld, an act relating to courts and making appropriation therefore to take effect immediately, bill related to the budget.
Thank you, Mr. President. Colleagues, thank you for your allowance to jump out of file order for just a moment. This, as the President said, is the last of our budget travel bills that need to get over to the Assembly so we can all complete our work today. You may remember that in March, we cut $200 million from our court system. Insult to injury, out of necessity, we cut another $150 million in June. The courts have come to us asking for some very minor mitigation to the pain that we have caused them, and that's what this court mitigation bill will do. It will eliminate a triggered reduction that regards existing civil filing fees. It will result in $6.9 million to the court. It also creates a responsive filing fee for appeals and Supreme Court reviews of $325. It was set, as is other responsive filing fees, at about 50% of what the original fees are, $655 for the Court of Appeal and $590 for the Supreme Court. And this will raise about $730,000 for the appellate court, which has taken a disproportional hit relative to the superior court. So that's why they've asked us to put forward this mitigation. And then lastly, it limits the sentencing transcripts trial courts must send to the Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation. Other transcripts will be available to both defendants and the department upon request. This then will reduce their workload, again, some savings for them. I ask for your aye vote in support of mitigating the damage we've done to the court system.
Is there debate or discussion? Senator Huff.
Thank you, Mr. President. As the chair of budget said, we hit the courts by $350 million this year as a part of trying to solve our budgetary problems. But how much budgetary savings does this bill accomplish? Zero. It creates new fees. It solves a problem in another way. We ramp up what we're charging people for courts because we didn't have the ability or desire to cut things in the budget. So we're raising fees in areas that we can. But now, when somebody wins a case, if the loser wants to appeal, the winner has to post a $325 fee. There's only five states that do this, and this is almost double what the next closest one does. But probably more importantly, you just saw on a previous bill the opportunity to save $100 million. And we touted that you know, we could save $100 million by consolidating elections to June. The legislative analyst has told us we could save $100 million by using electronic court reporting. That's actually a budgetary savings, not just having the consumer pay higher fees to cover the cost of court. Let's try to achieve these kinds of things by reforming the way we're doing things, looking for better practices, looking for newer technology, rather than just charging the user higher fees. I urge a no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Leno, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. President. As was discussed in the Budget Committee hearing, these are not just for cases that are moving from Superior to Court of Appeal. There are writs that are filed both in the Court of Appeal and the Supreme Court, which have not had any previous hearing. So this is just a court fee. Again, I've already described to you that it's proportional to other responsive court filing fees. And specifically, they are recoverable for the prevailing party. So this is a reasonable approach. Again, it was the courts that asked us to take up this measure. I would ask for your aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
No. Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee?
No.
No. Calderon?
Aye.
Aye. Cannella? No. Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton?
No.
No. Emerson?
No.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa? No. Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod? Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price? Rubio?
Aye.
Runner?
No.
Samedian? Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
No.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
No.
Wolk?
Aye.
Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
No.
Yee?
Aye.
Yee, aye.
Call the absent members.
Correa?
No.
Harmon? Negrete McLeod?
No.
Price?
Aye.
Aye. Smidian?
Aye.
Smidian, aye.
Ayes 23, no 16. The bill is passed. Senator Leno?
Mr. President, I request immediate transmittal to the Assembly, please.
Without objections, immediate transmittal is ordered. Members, we will return now to our place on the Assembly third reading file. We are at this time prepared to ask if the floor manager is ready to take up file item 36. File item 36, this is Senator Ted Lieu. You are prepared, sir? Let's ask the Secretary to please read.
Assembly Bill 362 by Assemblymember Bonnie Lowenthal and Acrolane to Elections.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. This bill modifies and clarifies write-in candidate requirements for Superior Court judges and other county offices. A loophole in current law has allowed many write-in candidates to not file the required documentation that the candidate is qualified to hold the office they seek. The flaw in this system came to light in 2008 when a known white supremacist took advantage of the low threshold and ran as a write-in candidate against six LA area judges with Hispanic surnames. This harassment ploy was a waste of taxpayer money and election officials' times, since these judges would have been left off the ballot if unopposed. This bill stops that kind of mischief, and it has no opposition and received unanimous support in a Senate Elections Committee. We start with the request and I vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee? Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella?
No.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
Aye.
De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton? Emerson? Evans? Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff? Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
Aye.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio? Runner? Smidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg? Strickland? Steinberg, aye. Strickland, no. Vargas?
Aye.
Aye. Walters?
No.
Wolk?
Aye.
Wright? Weiland?
No.
Yee?
Aye.
Yee, aye. Huff, no. Gaines, no to aye.
Mr. Secretary, call the absent members.
Gaines? No to aye. Blakeslee?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton? Emerson?
Aye.
Evans? Harmon? Rubio?
Aye.
Runner? Wright? Runner, aye. Weiland, no to aye.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Dutton? Evans? Harmon? Wright?
Ayes 29, no 7. The bill is passed. File item 37, Senator Correa. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 461 by Assemblymember Bonilla, an act relating to elections.
Thank you, Mr. President and Senators. This bill helps protect against voter disenfranchisement by ensuring that voters' intent is counted for write-in candidates during manual recounts. Current law regarding absentee and provisional voting provides for liberal construction when determining the voter's intent in the voter's favor. However, the law surrounding write-in candidates does not provide this same type of construction. This bill simply extends the same interpretation to include write-in candidates.
Is there a debate or discussion? Senator LaMalfa.
Thank you, Mr. President. It comes down again to personal responsibility, following the instructions on the ballot to be with the intent. I think that it just puts our elections in peril when we have more judgment calls made on ballots. The laws are pretty clear. The rules are pretty clear. Follow the instructions. Don't put stray marks on your ballot. Your ballot will be counted. If you do outside of that, then you get into privacy issues. You get into interpretation issues, which with what we have coming on other election laws and maybe even coming down to one vote per precinct, then every vote really becomes critical. And having somebody interpret that, I think, gets a little bit dangerous. I ask for your no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Correa, you may close.
Members, senators, this is really, again, against, this is about fairness. We invest tremendous amounts of money to make sure that our election system is a fair one, to make sure that every vote that is cast is counted. And well, what this bill says is fairness when it comes to write-in candidates. Let's make sure we count those ballots as well. I ask for an aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist. Aye. Anderson. No. Berryhill. No. Blakeslee. No. Calderon. Aye. Cannella. No. Corbett. Aye. Correa. Aye. De Leon. Aye. DeSaunier. Aye. Dutton. No. Emerson. No. Evans. Fuller. No. Gaines. No. Hancock. Aye. Harmon. Hernandez. Aye. Huff. No. Kehoe. Aye. LaMalfa. No. Leno. Aye. Ted Lieu. Aye. Carol Lieu. Aye. Lowenthal. Aye. Negrete McLeod. Aye. Padilla. Aye. Pavley. Aye. Price. Aye. Rubio. Aye. Runner. No. Sumidian.
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg. Aye. Strickland. No. Vargas. Aye. Walters. No. Wolk. Aye. Wright. Aye. Weiland. No. Yee. Yee, aye.
Call the absent members.
Evans. Harmon.
Ayes 24, noes 14. The bill is passed. File item 38. Senator De Leon, are you prepared to take this measure up? Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 1343 by Assemblymember Fong, an act relating to vote-by-mail procedures.
Thank you, Mr. President, as well as members. Since 2002, when state law was changed to allow any voter to become a permanent vote-by-mail voter, the number of Californians who are permanent vote-by-mail voters has actually shot up. In the year 2000, we had roughly about 300,000 individuals who are permanent vote-by-mail voters. Today, we have roughly about 6.5 million in the state of California. As a result, more than 3 out of every 8 registered voters in California are what we're known as permanent VBMs. Under existing law, a voter is removed from the permanent vote-by-mail list if he or she fails to return a ballot in 2 consecutive statewide general elections. As a result, we've had many voters have been prevented from voting if they don't realize that their names has been deleted, expunged from the list. AB 1343 allows voters to maintain their desired status as a permanent vote-by-mail voter by providing that a voter's name will be removed from the PVM list only if he or she fails in 4 consecutive statewide general elections. We're doing our best to make sure that everyone has an opportunity to continue to vote. Colleagues on both sides of the aisle, I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Senator LaMalfa.
As Vice Chair of Elections Committee, I have a duty to speak up on issues like this. And so we have a situation where you have ballots in the mail for 4 consecutive elections of people perhaps not picking up these ballots. You find them sometimes in the trash can. You could find them anywhere other than in the right hands of the right people. So to have this opportunity to purge from the vote-by-mail ballot situation, a chance for a little more election security. This does not purge anybody from being able to vote in person, but simply allows for a much tighter process of ensuring that mail-in ballots aren't falling into the wrong hands after only two elections instead of four. So this denies nobody their right to vote, their opportunity to vote, but just make sure that they're being a little more responsible about where their ballots are being sent to, and indeed in the right hands, not falling in the wrong hands. That's why I oppose this bill.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator De Leon, you may close.
Thank you much, Mr. President. I appreciate Mr. LaMalfa's, Senator LaMalfa's concerns. I just want to ensure to everybody here on the floor today that the same protections are added to Assembly Bill 1343 by Mr. Paul Fong. This is keyed also as a non-fiscal measure to, again, saving taxpayer dollars in the state of California. I respectfully ask for an aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? Blakeslee? No. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? No. Corbett? Aye. Correa?
Aye.
Aye. De Leon? Aye. DeSaunier?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton? No. Emerson? No. Evans? Fuller?
No.
No. Gaines? Hancock?
Aye.
Aye. Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? No. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? No. Smidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland?
No.
No. Vargas?
Aye.
Aye. Walters?
No.
No. Wolk?
Aye.
Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
No.
Yee?
Aye.
Yee, aye.
Anderson, no.
Call the absent members.
Berryhill?
No.
No. Evans? Gaines?
No.
No. Harmon?
Ayes 24, noes 14. The bill is passed. File item 39. Senator, no manager for this item. File item 40, there is no manager. File item 41, there is no manager. File item 42, there is no floor manager. File item 43, Senator Ted Lieu, are you prepared to take this up? You are, sir. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 433 by Assemblymember Bonnie Lowenthal and Acting to Vital Records.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. This bill simplifies the existing process by which a transgender person obtains appropriate identification documents. California's existing procedure for updating vital records can be difficult to navigate, and it conflicts with a medical standard applied by the U.S. State Department. The result is that many transgender people find themselves with a U.S. passport stating one gender and a birth certificate with another. This bill would alleviate that confusion, and it will bring the state's vital statistics law in line with federal standards by streamlining the existing process, making it easier to obtain an updated birth certificate. Respect the request, and I vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? Blakeslee? Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella? Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Dutton? Emerson? No. Evans? Fuller? Gaines? Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? No. Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla? Aye. Pavley?
Aye.
Price? Aye. Rubio? Runner? No. Smidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg.
Aye.
Aye. Strickland.
No.
Vargas.
Aye.
Aye. Walters.
No.
Wolk.
Aye.
Wright.
Aye.
Weiland.
No.
Yee. Yee. Aye. Anderson. No.
Members, one moment, please. Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Berryhill. No. Canella.
No.
Correa.
Aye.
Aye. Dutton.
No.
Evans. Fuller.
No.
Gaines. Harmon. Rubio.
Ayes 23, noes 13. The bill is passed. Members, if you could pause for a moment, and if I could ask you to direct your attention to the rear of our chambers, I want to welcome a very special guest today. Visiting us from the state of Oregon is Oregon Secretary of State, Kate Brown. Secretary Brown, we're very pleased to have you here. Welcome, and thank you for being with us.
Mr. President,
we'd be pleased to hear briefly from the Secretary of State from the state of Oregon.
State of Oregon, we want to welcome you and give you an opportunity to tell us all the good things you're doing in Oregon, briefly.
Thank you very much. I'm just delighted to be here today, and I'm here working with the Pew Center on voter registration modernization, working to make sure we get eligible voters on our voter registration database and making sure that the rolls are secure and integrous. So I'm just delighted to be here in the lovely state of California. Thank you.
Madam Secretary, it's a pleasure to have you here. Once more, members, please join me. Thank you. Thank you, members. We will return now to our place on file. The next item is file item 44. Is there a floor manager? Not. File item 45, Senator Ted Lieu. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 1026 by Assemblymember Knight and Act Relating to Assault.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. This bill makes it easier for prosecutors and public defenders to determine whether or not a defendant's prior conviction for assault with a deadly weapon involved great bodily injury. Under existing law, the same penal code addresses two types of crimes involving assault with a deadly weapon. This currently causes problems by clogging the court system with cases and motions to determine the true nature of the defendant's conviction. This bill creates more efficiency and accurate dispositions of criminal cases by simply splitting these two crimes into different sections. The bill is sponsored by the L.A. County District Attorney's Office, and I respectfully request an aye vote.
Is there debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Alquist.
Aye.
Aye. Anderson.
Aye.
Aye. Berryhill.
Aye.
Blakeslee.
Aye.
Aye. Calderon. Canella.
Aye.
Aye. Corbett.
Aye.
Correa.
Aye.
Aye. De Leon. Desaunier.
Aye.
Aye. Dutton. Emerson.
Aye.
Aye. Evans. Fuller.
Aye.
Aye. Gaines.
Aye.
Aye. Hancock. Harmon. Hernandez.
Aye.
Aye. Huff.
Aye.
Kehoe.
Aye.
Aye. LaMalfa.
Aye.
Aye. Leno.
Aye.
Aye. Ted Lieu.
Aye.
Aye. Carol Lieu.
Aye.
Lowenthal.
Aye.
Aye. Negrete McLeod. Padilla.
Aye.
Aye. Pavley.
Aye.
Aye. Price.
Aye.
Aye. Rubio.
Aye.
Aye. Runner.
Aye.
Aye. Simidian.
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg.
Aye.
Aye. Strickland.
Aye.
Aye. Vargas.
Aye.
Aye. Walters.
Aye.
Wolk.
Aye.
Wright.
Aye.
Weiland.
Aye.
Yee. Yee. Aye. Hancock. Aye. Calderon. Aye. De Leon. Aye. Dutton. Aye.
So we'll be at 46. Ayes 37. Noes 0. The bill is passed.
Already. Members, we are at file item 46. Mr. Price. And the secretary will read.
Assembly Bill 177 by Assemblymember Mendoza and Act Relating to Juveniles.
Senator Price.
Thank you, Madam President. Members, today I'm presenting AB 177 on behalf of Assemblymember Mendoza, a bill that expands the Parental Accountability Act and allows judges more discretion to assign anti-gang parenting classes to parents of minors for an offense in which a judge finds factors exist that indicate gang involvement or where a significant risk factor for gang involvement exists. According to the National Gang Center and the Los Angeles Police Department, juvenile delinquency is a precursor behavior to gang membership. These classes will help parents identify warning signs of gang involvement and teach parents how to communicate with children who may be headed down the wrong path. The bill has enjoyed bipartisan support, has not received any no votes, and I respectfully ask for your aye vote. Thank you.
Is there debate or discussion, members? Any debate? Any debate? Seeing none, can we ask for unanimous roll call? All right, we don't have any unanimous roll call. We will call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Aye. Anderson?
Aye.
Aye. Berryhill?
Aye.
Blakeslee?
Aye.
Aye. Calderon?
Aye.
Aye. Cannella?
Aye.
Aye. Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
Aye.
Aye. De Leon?
Aye.
Aye. DeSaunier?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton?
Aye.
Aye. Emerson? Aye. Evans? Fuller?
Aye.
Aye. Gaines? Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon. Hernandez.
Aye.
Aye. Huff.
Aye.
Kehoe.
Aye.
Aye. LaMoffa.
Aye.
Leno. Ted Lieu.
Aye.
Aye. Carol Lieu.
Aye.
Lowenthal.
Aye.
Aye. Negrete McLeod.
Aye.
Padilla.
Aye.
Pavley.
Aye.
Price.
Aye.
Aye. Rubio.
Aye.
Aye. Runner.
Aye.
Samedian. Steinberg.
Aye.
Strickland.
Aye.
Aye. Vargas.
Aye.
Aye. Walters.
Aye.
Aye. Wolk.
Aye.
Wright.
Aye.
Aye. Wyland.
Aye.
Aye. Yee.
Aye.
Yee. Aye.
Call the absent members.
Evans. Gaines.
Aye.
Aye. Harmon. Leno.
Aye.
Aye. Samedian. Samedian. Aye.
That is 38 ayes, no votes. The measure passes. Members, we're at file item 47. Ms. Evans, not at her desk. File item 48. Senator Lieu, are you prepared? The secretary will read.
Assembly Bill 1349 by Assemblymember Hill, an act relating to paternity.
Senator Lieu.
Thank you, Madam President, members. This bill clarifies the process by which judges, by allowing judges to consider the best interest of the child when determining legal paternity. The bill does not do anything more than simply clarify the process when two paternity presumptions are conflicting. This bill is sponsored by Equality California and the Academy of California Adoption Lawyers. Respect request and I vote.
Is there debate or discussion, members? Any debate or discussion? Seeing none. Is there an objection to unanimous? All right, we'll call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
No. Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee?
No.
Calderon? Cannella?
No.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Dutton?
No.
Emerson?
No.
Evans? Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff? Kehoe?
Aye.
Aye. LaMoffa? Leno?
Aye.
Aye. Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Aye. Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio? Runner? Smidian? Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
No.
Vargas?
Aye.
Aye. Walters?
No.
No. Wolk?
Aye.
Wright? Wyland?
No.
Yee?
Aye.
Yee. Aye.
Call the absent members.
Huff? No. Calderon? Correa? Evans? Harmon? LaMoffa?
No.
Rubio? Runner? Smidian? Smidian, aye. Wright. Runner, no.
Senator Lieu moves a call.
Members, we are at file item 49. Is there a floor manager? File item 50. File item 51. Senator Saulnier, are you prepared to take this item up? Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 607 by Assemblymember Brownlee, an act relating to vehicles.
Thank you, Mr. President. AB 607 allows for a pilot program for the Santa Monica Transit Agency to do illuminated digital advertising on the sides of their bus. It's a five-year program. It will limit it to 25 signs. There's reporting from the CHP and the Santa Monica Police Department to report to the legislature on the safety impacts of this advertising. Has the potential to raise $4 to $6 million, much needed funds for transit that we can learn on a statewide basis from, and I would ask for your aye vote.
Yes.
Is there debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Secretary, call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? Aye. Blakeslee? Aye. Calderon? Canella? Aye. Corbett? Aye. Correa? Aye. De Leon? Aye. DeSaulnier?
Aye.
Aye. Dutton? Emerson? Aye. Oh, Dutton, aye. Emerson?
Aye.
Aye. Evans? Fuller? Aye. Gaines? Aye. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? Aye. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? Aye. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Lowenthal? Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? No. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? Aye. Smidian?
No.
Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
Aye.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
Aye.
Wolk? Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
Aye.
Yee? Yee, aye. Corbett, aye to no. Wolk, aye.
Anderson,
aye.
Please call the absent members.
Calderon? Evans, Harmon, Carol Lieu, aye, Lowenthal.
Ayes 33, noes 3, the bill is passed. Members, we're at file item 52. Is there a floor manager? File item 53, is there a floor manager? File item 54, is there a floor manager? Senator Hancock, are you prepared to take this item up? If so, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Joint Resolution 10 by Assemblymember Brownlee relative to school-based health centers.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. A student's health is frequently linked with a student's success in the classroom. Unfortunately, more than 1.5 million California children are uninsured. These students who do not see dentists or doctors regularly are more likely to get sick and miss valuable time in the classroom. School-based health centers begin to address the problem of health, meeting the basic health needs for these young people. AJR 10 recognizes the benefits of the school-based health center program and requests the United States Congress to appropriate funds for the school-based health center program through the Federal Patient Protection and Affordable Health Care Act. Healthy students are more likely to be successful students. AJR 10 gives us a unique opportunity to support both health and education for our children. I would ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson?
No.
Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? Calderon? Blakeslee, no. Calderon? Canella? No. Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon? DeSaulnier?
Aye.
Dutton?
Aye.
Emerson?
No.
Evans? Fuller? No. Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla? Aye, Pavley. Aye, Price. Aye, Rubio. Runner. No, Simidian. Aye, Steinberg. Aye, Strickland. No, Vargas. Aye, Walters. No, Wolk. Aye, Wright. Weiland. No, Yee. Yee, aye. Dutton, aye to no.
Call the absent members.
Calderon, aye. Correa, De Leon, aye. Evans, Harmon, Rubio, aye. Wright, right, aye. Correa, aye.
Ayes 24, noes 14. The resolution is adopted. Members, we're at file item 55, no floor manager. File item 50. Members, if we could have order in the chamber. File item 55. The file shows no floor manager for this item. Is there a floor manager? Senator Price. Thank you. We are going to ask the secretary to please read.
Assembly Concurrent Resolution 54 by Assemblymember Mitchell relative to American Stroke Month 2011.
Thank you. May proceed, Senator.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, I'm pleased to present this resolution on behalf of Assemblymember Holly Mitchell. A current resolution, better not, simply declares May 2011 as American Stroke Month. According to the American Heart Association, nearly 800,000 Americans each year suffer from a new or recurring stroke. Stroke is also the third largest leading cause of death in the United States and accounts for one out of every 18 deaths that occur in our nation. Although this resolution singles out the month of May for special recognition, all Californians should be mindful throughout the year of the importance of educating ourselves on the warning signs and symptoms of stroke. Please join me today in supporting this resolution. I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Secretary, please call the roll.
Alquist. Aye. Anderson. Berryhill. Aye. Blakesley. Aye. Calderon. Aye. Cannella. Aye. Corbett. Aye. Correa. De Leon. DeSaunier. Aye. Dutton. Aye. Emerson. Aye. Evans. Fuller. Aye. Gaines. Aye. Hancock. Aye. Harmon. Hernandez. Aye. Huff. Aye. Kehoe. Aye. LaMalfa. Leno. Aye. Ted Lieu. Aye. Carol Lieu. Aye. Lowenthal. Aye. Negrete McLeod. Aye. Padilla. Aye. Pavley. Aye. Price. Aye. Rubio. Runner. Aye. Simidian. Aye. Steinberg. Aye. Strickland. Aye. Vargas. Aye. Walters. Aye. Wolk. Aye. Wright. Aye. Weiland. Aye. Yee. Yee. Aye. Anderson. Aye. Correa. Aye. Rubio. Aye.
Secretary, please call the absent members.
De Leon, Evans, Harmon, LaMalfa. LaMalfa, aye.
Please call the absent members.
De Leon, Evans, Harmon.
Ayes 37, noes 0. The resolution is adopted. Members, we are at file item 56. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 503 by Assemblymember Block, an act relating to elections.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, members, for allowing me to present. This is a companion bill to AB 461 that we heard recently. AB 503 ensures that all write-in votes for qualified candidates can be counted, even if the voter forgets to fill in the bubble next to the space. A bedrock principle of our democracy is one person, one vote. Every person's vote should be counted. The integrity of an election depends on it. However, in 2004, mayoral candidate in San Diego had more than 5,500 votes thrown out.
Senator Vargas, one moment, please, yes. While the House comes to order. Members, if we could ask you to direct your attention to Senator Vargas. Senator Vargas, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. I know they were riveted by my speech. I appreciate it. However, in 2004, a mayoral candidate in San Diego had more than 5,500 votes thrown out by a judge because the voters wrote their name but forgot to fill in the bubble next to the write-in line. Without these votes, the second-place person was certified as the winner of the election. This bill is sponsored by the Secretary of State and is supported by the Californians Aware, Common Cause, Environmental Health Coalition, the League of Women Voters, and the California chapter of the National Organization of Women. Again, I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Senator LaMalfa, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Please substitute my last two speeches on voter responsibility and ballot integrity in my opposition on this bill. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Vargas, you may close.
Please substitute my close and ask for an aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, one moment, please, Mr. Secretary. Members, I'm advised by the Secretary that there's some difficulty in hearing the votes cast, particularly for those of you who are in the bay to the side of the chambers. If members could be quiet during the roll call and if members in the bay could speak up, that will ensure that your vote is recorded. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? No. Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? No. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? No. Corbett? Aye. Correa? De Leon? Aye. Desaunier? Aye. Dutton? No. Emerson? Evans? Fuller? No. Gaines? No. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? No. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? No. Simidian? Steinberg?
Aye.
Aye. Strickland? No. Vargas? Aye. Walters? No. Wolk? Wright? Aye. Weiland? No. Yee? Yee, aye. Emerson, no. Correa, aye. Padilla, aye.
Call the absent members.
Evans, Harmon, Carol Lieu, aye. Simidian, aye. Wolk.
That is ayes 23, noes 14. The bill is passed. File item 57, Senator Wright. Pass. File item 58, Senator Wright. Pass. File item 59, is there a floor manager? File item 60, Senator LaMalfa. Not at his desk. File item 61, Senator Huff. Mr. Secretary, please read. File item 61, members.
Assembly Bill 307 by Assemblymember Nastande, an acrylene to joint powers agreements.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, AB 307 will include Native American tribes in the statutory definition of public agencies eligible to participate in a joint powers authority, or JPA. In order to fulfill public needs, the members of a JPA can cooperatively exercise existing powers that are common to the members. Such services include water reclamation, regional planning, and fire services. Currently, each time a tribe wishes to join a JPA, separate legislation must be approved to authorize such an agreement. Today, however, many tribal governments have the resources and sophistication to engage in large-scale economic development, infrastructure, construction, and community services beyond their tribal membership. Tribal governments already operate schools, housing programs, clinics, elderly care, and fire departments. It's time to recognize California tribal governments as equal partners in progress and allow tribes to more easily participate in the network of social services provided to local communities. This bill is supported by the United Auburn Indian community, as well as other tribes and local government agencies that are looking forward to working together on projects of mutual interest. I ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? Any objection? Seeing and hearing none, ayes 38, noes 0, the bill is passed. Members, that takes us to file item 62. Is there a floor manager? File item 63, Senator Kehoe. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 140 by Assemblymember Fuentes, an act relating to the payment of claims against the state, making appropriation therefore, and declaring the urge thereof to take effect immediately.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, this is one of our annual claims bills sponsored by the Department of Justice. It would appropriate $232,000 from the general fund to pay two claims as a result of court actions. Department of Finance supports the measure. There's no known opposition. It left Senate Appropriations Committee on an 8-0 vote. As for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Secretary call the roll.
Ahlquist. Aye. Anderson. Berryhill. Blakeslee. Calderon. Aye. Cannella. Aye. Corbett. Aye. Correa. Aye. De Leon. Aye. Desaunier. Aye. Dutton. Aye. Emerson. Aye. Evans. Fuller. Aye. Gaines. Aye. Hancock. Aye. Herman. Hernandez. Aye. Huff. Kehoe. Aye. LaMalfa. Aye. Leno. Aye. Ted Lieu. Aye. Carol Lieu. Aye. Lowenthal. Aye. Negrete McLeod. Aye. Padilla. Aye. Pavley. Aye. Price. Aye. Rubio. Aye. Runner. Aye. Sumidian.
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg. Aye. Strickland. Aye. Vargas.
Aye.
Walters. Aye. Wolk. Wright. Aye. Wyland. Aye. Yee. Yee. Aye. Huff. Aye. Berryhill. Aye. Anderson. Aye. Blakeslee. Aye.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Evans. Harmon. Wolk.
Ayes 37, no 0 on the urgency. Ayes 37, no 0 on the bill. The bill is passed. Senator LaMalfa, for what purpose do you rise, sir?
Maybe we can go back to file 60, please.
Returning to file item 60. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 1125 by Assemblymember Ashajian, an act relating to wastewater collection and treatment.
Thank you. This is a measure I supported in Governance and Finance Committee that deals with the Los Osos sewer district created recently in 2006, actually. This helps those folks in the low-income situation that are having difficulty paying the rates. It does not affect other ratepayers. Other funds are used, substituted to help out with the low-income people keeping up with those sewer rates. So it's a very good measure here that I'm happy to support and ask your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none. Members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? Any objection? If not, ayes 38, no 0. The bill is passed. Thank you, members. Returning to our place on file. File item 64. Senator Ted Lieu, you are prepared to present. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 84 by Assemblymember Fong, an act relating to elections.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. This bill ensures all U.S. citizens have the right to vote in California elections by allowing individuals who become citizens after the voter registration deadline to register and vote until the close of polls on election day. The bill has no opposition, is supported by several civil rights organizations. Respectfully request an aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, call the roll.
Ahlquist, aye. Anderson, Berryhill, no. Blakeslee, Calderon, aye. Cannella, no. Corbett, aye. Correa, De Leon, aye. Desaunier, aye. Dutton, no. Emerson, no. Evans, Fuller, no. Gaines, no. Hancock, aye. Herman, Hernandez, aye. Huff, Kehoe, aye. LaMalfa, no. Leno, aye. Ted Lieu, aye. Carol Lieu, aye. Lowenthal, Negrete McLeod, aye. Padilla, aye. Pavley, aye. Price,
Aye, Rubio. Aye, Runner.
No,
Simidian.
Aye,
Steinberg.
Aye,
Strickland. No, Vargas.
Aye,
Walters. Wolk. Wright.
Aye.
Weiland.
No,
Yee.
Yee,
aye. Walters, no.
Correa, aye.
Correa, aye. Anderson, no.
Please call the absent members, Mr. Secretary.
Blakeslee.
No.
No. Evans. Harmon. Huff. No. Lowenthal. Wolk.
Ayes 22, noes 14. The bill is passed. File item 65. Senator Wright, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 123 by Assemblymember Mendoza, an act linked to school safety.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, this bill, to my knowledge, has no opposition. It gives local school administrators and local law enforcement the ability to address disruptions and some demonstrations that occurred for the safety of children going to and from school. It evolves from a court case where there was a demonstration and the court ruled that the school district could not call law enforcement to protect children who were going to and from school. Again, it has no opposition that I'm aware of. The Ninth Circuit said that the legislature could enact a statute that would provide the necessary protection, but since it wasn't done at the time that this case was heard, then the case was thrown out. This law is written in response to that action by the Ninth Circuit. I'm not aware of any opposition. It's supported by much of law enforcement and many of the school districts, and I would ask for an aye vote.
Is there debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Alquist.
Aye.
Anderson.
No.
Berryhill.
Aye.
Blakeslee.
Aye.
Aye. Calderon.
Aye.
Cannella. Corbett.
Aye.
Correa. De Leon.
Aye.
DeSaunier. Dutton. Emerson. Evans. Fuller.
Aye.
Gaines. Hancock.
Aye.
Harmon. Hernandez.
Aye.
Huff. No. Kehoe.
Aye.
LaMalfa.
No.
Leno.
Aye.
Ted Lieu.
Aye.
Carol Lieu.
Aye.
Lowenthal.
Aye.
Negrete McLeod.
No.
Padilla.
Pavley.
Aye. Price.
Aye.
Rubio.
Aye.
Runner.
Aye.
Simidian.
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg.
Aye.
Aye. Strickland.
No.
No. Vargas.
Aye.
Aye. Walters.
No.
Wolk. Wright. Weiland. Yee.
Yee, aye.
Correa, aye. Evans, aye. Emerson, aye.
Members, one moment, please. Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Cannella. DeSaunier.
Aye.
Dutton.
Aye.
Gaines.
No.
Harmon. Padilla.
Aye.
Wolk. Wright.
Aye.
Weiland.
Aye.
Weiland, aye.
Ayes 30, noes 7. The bill is passed. Senator Ted Lieu, for what purpose do you rise, sir?
I'd like to lift a call on file item 48.
Lifting the call on file item 48. Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Calderon.
Aye.
Correa. Evans.
Aye.
Harmon.
Rubio.
Aye. Wright.
Once again, ayes 23, noes 14. The bill is passed. Members, returning to our place on file, we are now at file item 66. Is there a floor manager? Apparently not. File item 67, no floor manager. File item 68, Senator Evans, are you prepared to take this item up? Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 312 by Assemblymember Bonnie Lowenthal, an act linked to civil rights.
Thank you, Mr. President. Sorry for the delay. This is AB 312 by Assemblymember Bonnie Lowenthal. It deals with protection of homeless veterans. California has one of the largest homeless populations in the country, about 157,000 people, and a third of those homeless are veterans. Sadly, California has been recently identified as the state having the highest rate of violence against homeless people. Until recently, that unfortunate distinction belonged to Florida, but Florida has adopted protections which are similar to those in this bill that's before you today, and Florida's rate of violence against its homeless veterans has gone down. Homeless people make easy prey. Not only are they out in the open, but often they suffer from physical and mental disabilities. AB 312 would help address that problem with some much-needed protections. I ask for an aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Secretary, call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee?
No.
Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella?
No.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
Aye.
De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Dutton? No. Emerson?
No.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio?
Aye.
Runner? No. Sumidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg? Strickland?
No.
No. Vargas?
Aye.
Aye. Walters?
No.
Wolk? Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
No.
No. Yee? Yee, aye.
Ayes 23, noes 14. The bill is passed. File item 69, there is no floor manager. File item 70, Senator DeSaulnier. Has been done. Thank you. File item 71, no floor manager. File item 72, no floor manager. File item 73, no floor manager. File item 74, 75, no floor manager. File item 76, Senator Carol Lieu. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 835 by Assemblymember Mitchell, an accolade to community colleges.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, AB 835 is a measure that will calls for better coordination between career tech ed programs, high schools, and community colleges in order to maximize student participation. Studies have shown that students who complete career technical education courses are significantly more likely to pursue higher education and have higher paying jobs. AB 835 removes administrative barriers that have prevented students from diverse geographic regions from participating in in-depth career exploration to gain marketable skills that will assist them in developing a career upon graduation. This bill has enjoyed bipartisan support, has no registered opposition, and I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson? Berryhill?
Aye.
Blakeslee?
Aye.
Aye. Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella? Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier?
Aye.
Dutton?
Aye.
Emerson?
Aye.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
Aye.
Gaines?
Hancock?
Aye. Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe? Kehoe, aye. LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu? Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio?
Aye.
Runner?
Aye.
Sumidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
Aye.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
No.
Wolk? Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
Aye.
Aye. Yee? Yee, aye.
Correa, aye.
Cannella, aye.
Please call the absent members.
Anderson?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Anderson, no to aye. Gaines? Carol Liu?
Aye.
Wolk?
Ayes 35, noes 3. The bill is passed. File item 77. We have no floor manager. File item 78, Mr. Wright. Mr. Secretary, please read. We are at file item 78.
Assembly Bill 1338 by Assemblymember Roger Hernandez, an act relating to redevelopment.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, this bill was on consent. It was pulled off consent to make some amendments. There were erroneous references to the health and safety code. Has not had any no votes in the assembly or the Senate. Went to the Senate Governance and Finance Committee, where it passed unanimously. It requires a third-party appraisal in a redevelopment agency transaction. Might be irrelevant given what we have already done relative to that, but in the event that it comes back, this would be very relevant because it would say that there'd be a third-party appraisal to verify that properties sold would be fairly assessed. I'd ask for an aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? Any objection to substituting the unanimous roll call? If not, ayes 38, noes 0. The bill is passed. File item 79. Senator Evans, are you prepared to take this item up? No, not at this time. File item 80, there is no floor manager. File item 81, there is no floor manager. File item 82, Senator Carol Liu. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 1400 by the Assembly Committee on Human Services, an act relating to public social services.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, AB 1400 is a joint Assembly and Senate Committee cleanup bill that came out of both policy committees with unanimous votes. This bill updates a new name for the food stamp program throughout code. It's now CalFresh. It deletes obsolete code sections and corrects references to the old name of the Health and Human Services Agency, and I ask for your aye vote.
Thank you, Senator Liu. Sounds like you have an enthusiastic supporter in the gallery. Is there debate or discussion on the floor? Seeing and hearing none, any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? There is. Please call the roll.
Alquist? Aye. Anderson? No. Berryhill? Aye. Blakeslee? Calderon? Canella?
Aye.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
Aye.
De Leon?
Aye.
Desaunier?
Aye.
Dutton?
Aye.
Emerson?
Aye.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
Aye.
Gaines? Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
Aye.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
Aye.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Liu?
Aye.
Carol Liu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod? Padilla?
Aye.
Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio?
Aye.
Runner?
Aye.
Simidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
Aye.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
Aye.
Wolk? Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
Aye.
Yee?
Yee,
aye. Blakeslee, aye. Negrete McLeod, aye.
Call the absent members.
Calderon?
Aye.
Gaines? Harmon? Wolk?
Ayes 36, noes 1. The bill is passed. File item 83, there is no floor manager. File item 84, Senator Leno, are you prepared to take this item up? If so, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 686 by Assemblymember Huffman, an act relating to taxation.
Thank you, Mr. President. Colleagues, as we're well aware, we have a state sales and use tax structure which amounts to 8.25%. Local authorities have the opportunity to raise what's called a transaction use transactions and use tax between a quarter, 0.25%, and 2%. And that benefits fire, police, parks, schools, libraries. All this bill does is follows the allowance for libraries to put before voters a transactions and use tax of 0.125, meaning an eighth as opposed to a quarter percent. So there was a situation in Marin County where a particular special district wanted to raise part of the sales tax, put it before voters. They didn't need 0.25%. It was more money than they needed. They wanted to put before voters 0.125%. They didn't have that authority. That's all this bill does. It has not changed the threshold by which a county board of supervisors or city council puts the measure on the ballot. It does not change the threshold by which voters must approve it. It just allows for that smaller increment. As I say, there's already precedent for library construction and improvement. I ask for your aye vote.
Is there debate or discussion, members? Seeing and hearing, Senator Huff.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. Well, again, this underscores our appetite to transfer things down to the local level. We already have one of the highest sales and use tax in the nation. Actually, it is already the highest. So why are we making it easier for local governments to raise taxes? It'll only encourage people to shop outside of their own county, which inevitably hurt local businesses and make them less competitive. This bill gives shoppers more incentive to shop online to avoid paying the sales tax. However, the legislature is now forcing out-of-state retailers to collect sales tax from California, so where are shoppers supposed to go? We need to help taxpayers through these difficult financial times and keep businesses in our state. This bill doesn't do that. I urge a no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Leno, you may close.
Thank you, colleagues. Let me just clarify. Opposition statements notwithstanding, this does not raise anyone's taxes, doesn't even give any new authority to raise anyone's taxes. It allows for a smaller increment to be put before a county board of supervisors or a city council, which by a two-thirds majority vote must decide whether or not to let the voters decide. Local control, voter determination to raise a sales tax they're already allowed to raise in a smaller increment. I ask for your aye vote.
Call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee?
No.
Calderon?
Aye.
Cannella? Corbett?
Aye.
Correa? De Leon?
Aye.
DeSaunier? Dutton? No. Emerson? No. Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
No.
Hancock?
Aye.
Harmon? Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu?
Aye.
Carol Lieu?
Aye.
Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod? Padilla? Negrete McLeod? No. Padilla? Aye. Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio?
Aye.
Runner? No. Sumidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
No.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
No.
Wolk? Wright?
Aye.
Weiland?
No.
Yee?
Yee,
aye.
Call the absent members.
Cannella, no. Correa?
No.
DeSaunier? Harmon? Wolk?
Ayes 21, no 16. The bill is passed. Members on file items 85 and 86. Senator Wolk is briefly absent from the chamber, working in the assembly. We will return to these items upon her return. File item 87. Senator Rubio, are you prepared to take this item up? File item 87, not at this time. File item 88, no floor manager. File item 89. Senator Lowenthal, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assemblybill 462 by Assemblymember Bonnie Lowenthal, an accolade to air pollution.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. AB 462 is one of those bills that actually saves us money while still ensuring a healthier environment for us and, more importantly, for our children. Clean Air Act money has allowed school districts since 1990 to purchase natural gas-powered school buses. While the first batch of these buses have a service life of another 10 to 15 years, Their fuel tanks are reaching the end of their 15-year lifespan. This bill allows school districts to use the same funds to replace the tanks on these otherwise perfectly good buses. They do not have to now purchase new buses. They can just replace the fuel tanks. It also allows them to replace or upgrade deteriorating fuel dispensers. This bill passed out of the Senate EQ committee with unanimous support. It has no known opposition. I respectfully ask for your aye vote in this sensible bill.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call? Call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? Berryhill, aye. Blakeslee? Aye. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? Aye. Corbett? Aye. Correa? Aye. De Leon? Aye. DeSaunier? Dutton? Aye. Emerson? Aye. Evans? Aye. Fuller? Aye. Gaines? Aye. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? Aye. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? Aye. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carolu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? Aye. Semidian? Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland? Aye. Vargas? Aye. Walters? Aye. Wolk? Wright? Aye. Weiland? Aye. Yee? Yee, aye. Anderson, aye.
Please call the absent members.
DeSaunier? Harmon? Negrete McLeod? Wolk?
Ayes 36, noes 0. The bill is passed. File item 90. There is no floor manager. File item 91, Senator Ted Lieu. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Concurrent Resolution 34 by Assemblymember Lara, relative to ethnic studies.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. ACR 34 recognizes the invaluable contributions of California's ethnic studies departments and programs, including their faculty, staff, and students. Created in our universities as a response to a student-led movement of the 1960s, ethnic studies were achieved through great struggles, including demonstrations, student protests, and hunger strikes. Students, faculty, and community members demanded university courses that were relevant to them and their communities. This ACR recognizes these struggles, as well as the thousands of beneficiaries of ethnic studies programs. The resolution also supports the continuation of ethnic studies in our K-12 public schools. I respect the request and I vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? No. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? Aye. Corbett? Aye. Correa? De Leon? Aye. DeSaunier? Dutton? No. Emerson? No. Evans? Aye. Fuller? No. Gaines? No. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? Hernandez? Aye. Huff? Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carolu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? No. Semidian? Aye. Steinberg? Strickland? Vargas? Strickland, no. Vargas, aye. Walters? No. Wolk? Wright? Aye. Weiland? No. Yee? Yee, aye. Correa, aye.
Correa, aye.
Anderson, no.
Call it. Please call the absent members.
DeSaunier, Harmon, Huff, LaMalfa, no. Blakeslee, no to aye. Steinberg, Wolk.
Ayes 24, noes 11. That resolution is adopted. Senator Simidian, for what purpose do you rise?
Thank you, Mr. President. At this time, I'd like to take up file item 180.
Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 360 by Assemblymember Brownlee, an act relating to charter schools.
Members, this measure simply requires charter schools to comply with the same conflict of interest policies as any other school district. Would require that charter schools comply with the Brown Act or the Bagley-Keene Act, whichever applies, with the Public Records Act, the Political Reform Act, and specifies that members of charter school boards may not be financially interested in any decision made by the board. This is consistent with Government Code Section 1090. This is part of a larger package of compromise efforts that Ms. Brownlee is to be credited with. While there's been a lot of debate, push and shove around charter issues over the years, the one place where I think we can agree is we want to make sure that conflict of interest provisions, open government provisions, provide the same protections for charter schools as they do for any other schools. The measure is supported by the California Charter Schools Association, and I would respectfully request an aye vote.
Thank you, Senator Smith. Any discussion or debate? Any discussion or debate? Secretary, please call the roll.
Alquist, aye. Anderson, Berryhill, no. Blakeslee, no. Calderon, aye. Canella, no. Corbett, aye. Correa, aye. De Leon, aye. Desaunier, Dutton, no. Emerson, Evans, aye. Fuller, no. Gaines, no. Hancock, aye. Herman, Hernandez, aye. Huff, no. Kehoe, aye. LaMalfa, Leno, aye. Ted Liu, aye. Carol Liu, aye. Lowenthal, aye. Negrete McLeod, aye. Padilla, aye. Pavley, aye. Price,
aye.
Aye. Rubio, aye. Runner, no. Simidian, aye. Steinberg, Strickland, no. Vargas, aye. Walters, aye. Wolk, Wright, aye. Weiland, no. Yee, Yee, aye. Emerson, aye. Anderson, no.
Ayes 24, noes 11. That measure is adopted.
And passed.
Thank you, members. We are returning to our place on file. That is file item 92. Senator Pavley, you're prepared to take up this item. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Assembly Bill 818.
Forgive me.
Assembly Bill 818 by Assemblymember Blumenfield, an act relating to recycling.
Yes, thank you very much, Mr. President. Members, this bill by Assemblymember Blumenfield is called the Renters' Right to Recycle Act. Less than 40% of the 7 million apartment owners around California have the ability to recycle even if they want to do so. I'd like to share with you that this bill only applies to apartment buildings of 5 units or more. Mr. Blumenfield's worked through extensive negotiations with all a variety of stakeholders. There's no opposition. Exemptions were built into that to take into consideration lack of space or excessive costs, or even if there's a recycling program available to that community. This bill is necessary because there are too many renters who do not have access to recycling, and as you know, local governments are under pressure to meet their 50% mandate in waste diversion. This is a reasonable bill, and everyone who wants to recycle should have the ability to do so. I ask for your aye vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none. Mr. Secretary, call the roll.
Alquist, aye. Anderson, no. Berryhill, no. Blakeslee, Calderon, aye. Canella, Corbett, aye. Correa, De Leon, aye. Desaunier, Dutton, no. Emerson, no. Evans, aye. Fuller, no. Gaines, no. Hancock, aye. Herman, Hernandez, aye. Huff, no. Kehoe,
Aye.
LaMalfa? No. Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Aye. Runner? No. Sumedian?
Aye.
Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
No.
Vargas?
Aye.
Walters? No. Wolk? Wright? Weiland? No. Yee? Yee, aye.
Call the absent members.
Blakesley?
Aye.
Canella? Correa?
Aye.
Desaunye? Harmon? Wolk? Wright? Wright, aye.
Ayes 24, noes 12. The bill is passed. File item 93. Senator Hancock, up. One moment. Yes, Senator Palvey, for what purpose do your ayes?
Excuse me. At the request of the past author, Mr. Blumenfeld, he would like immediate transmittal back to the Assembly.
Without objection, so ordered.
Thank you.
Senator Hancock. Mr. Secretary, please read file item 93. This is AB 587, members. Mr. Secretary.
Assembly Bill 587 by Assemblymember Gordon, an act relating to public works.
Thank you, Mr. President and Senators. AB 587 extends the sunset date on the public works exemption for volunteers and Conservation Corps members for 5 years until January 1st, 2017. Continuing an exemption that has been in place for over 7 years. The ability to volunteer is essential for many civic projects, from school children to senior citizens. Many community members are key partners in tree planting, beach cleaning, restoring creeks and trails. Sometimes these are part of school-based learning for our children's education. Extending this sunset provision will allow California to continue to tap into one of our greatest resources, the generosity of the human spirit. There is no opposition. I ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? 37. Ayes 37, noes 0. The bill is passed. Members, that takes us to file item 94. We are at file item 94. Senator Carol Lieu, are you prepared to take up this item? Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 504 by Assemblymember Williams, an act relating to taxation.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, AB 504 clarifies that Santa Barbara School District can maintain existing parcel tax revenue after their elementary and high school districts unify. Without clarifying legislation, unification of the districts could result in the nullification of locally approved parcel taxes. This bill would further allow the unified school district to levy future parcel taxes as they do now, so that residents only continue to pay for those schools that serve their community as they do now. So AB 504 is sponsored by the Santa Barbara School District. It has no opposition, and I ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, members, is there any objection to substituting the unanimous roll call on this item? Seeing and hearing none, ayes 36, noes 0. The bill is passed. Members, that takes us to file item 95. Senator Yee, are you prepared to take this measure up? Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Joint Resolution 3 by Assemblymember Dickinson, relative to taxation.
Thank you very much, Mr. President and Senators. This measure is sponsored by the California Airports Council. It urges Congress to extend the alternative minimum tax holiday for private activity bonds like those used by airports in order to maintain a strong capital investment at our California airports. In 2008, Congress enacted the American Recovery and Investment Act, which included the alternative minimum tax a holiday for 2009 and 2010 taxable year. As a result, this particular measure then allow rather favorable financing terms that allow investors to be encouraged to do what they can to help with capital improvement in our airports and expansion projects across the state. Unfortunately, the AMT holiday expired in December 2010. despite several attempts at Congress to extend that. What this measure will do is to urge Congress to extend this holiday and hopefully with that provide capital for our airports throughout California for that maintenance expansion. With that, urge an aye vote.
Further debate or discussion? Further debate or discussion? Members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? Any objection to substituting the unanimous roll call? Seeing and hearing none, ayes 37, noes 0. The resolution is adopted. Members, that takes us to file item 96. Senator Walters, you are prepared to present. Let's ask the Secretary to read, please. Oh, one moment, Senator Walters. Senator Lowenthal, for what purpose do you rise, sir?
Permission to remove an item from special consent.
Without objection.
I'd like to remove item 221, AB 712, from the special consent calendar at the request of the author.
Duly noted and so ordered. Thank you, Senator Walters. Mr. Secretary, please read. We are at file item 96, members.
Assembly Bill 571 by Assemblymember Hagman, an acrolane to corporations.
Thank you, Mr. President and Senators. AB 571 clarifies and cleans up provisions of the Corporations Code relating to dividends and redemptions of shares. Recent amendments were technical amendments agreed to in committee. There is no opposition, and I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? Any objection to substituting the unanimous roll call on this item? If not, ayes 37, noes 0, the bill is passed. File item 97, Senator Carol Liu, pass. File item 98, no floor manager. File item 99, no floor manager. File item 100, no floor manager. File item 101, no floor manager. File item 102, no floor manager. File item 103. Senator Emerson, are you prepared to take this item up? If so, Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 655 by Assemblymember Hayashi, an acrolane to healing arts.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. Assembly Bill 655 will improve the peer review system in California by encouraging peer review bodies to share information with each other. This bill seeks to reduce the possible risks and liabilities of sharing peer review information, both for the peer review bodies and for the physicians under review. Recent floor amendments provide that all relevant peer review information produced shall be made available to the licensure, the licensed by requesting peer review bodies in accordance with current law. AB 655 is one step California can take to improve the physician peer review system and ultimately ensure high quality patient care and safety. I respectfully ask for an aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call? If not, ayes 37, noes 0, the bill is passed. File item 104, there is no floor manager. File item 105, Senator Carol Liu, are you prepared to take this item up? Indeed. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Assembly Concurrent Resolution 53 by Assemblymember Roger Hernandez relative to perinatal depression prevention.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Members, ACR 53, also known as Kelly Abraham Martinez Act, designates the month of May as Perinatal Depression Awareness Month. Kelly Abram Act urges hospital providers, mental health providers, health plans, and insurers to educate women about prenatal depression and its risk factors. Request a statewide collaborative network of stakeholders focused on the area of health, maternal health, infant, and child development to collaborate and explore ways to develop perinatal depression prevention educational materials. This resolution recognizes the need for our communities to work together in order to provide existing resources that spread awareness and prevention of perinatal depression. This bill is sponsored by the Junior League of California and the LA County Perinatal Mental Health Task Force, and I have passed out the assembly with unanimous votes, and I ask for your support on the bill.
Members, is there any debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, is there any objection to substituting the unanimous roll call on this item? Seeing and hearing no objection, ayes 37, no 0. The resolution is adopted. Senator Ted Lieu, for what purpose do you rise, sir?
Can we go back to file item 104, please?
File item 104. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Joint Resolution 12 by Assemblymember Solario relative to the Strengthening Medicare and Repaying Taxpayers Act of 2011.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. This AJR expresses the support of the California Legislature for H.R. 1063, the Medicare Secondary Payer Enhancement Act. Today, Medicare has a right to collect payments it has conditionally made to the aged and disabled that are the primary responsibility of employers or insurance companies, and to assure that settlements and workers' compensation claims take into account Medicare's interest when funding future medical obligations. Unfortunately, victims of accidents and workplace injuries are now faced with substantial delays and uncertainty when navigating this time-consuming and costly process. H.R. 1063 will bring certainty to the termination of amounts owed to Medicare, thus resolving these obligations more promptly. This AJR is supported by a broad coalition. Research request and I vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none. Members, is there any objection to substituting our unanimous roll call on this item? If not, ayes 37, noes 0. The resolution is adopted. Members, at this time, we are going to go to file item 148. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Assembly Bill 130 by Assemblymember Cedillo, an act relating to student financial aid.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. Brings me great pride today in presenting a measure that's 10 years in the making. AB 130 is called the DREAM Act, and it's about supporting those who work hard, play by the rules, and want to improve the standards of living. Working hard to achieve one's dreams is a strong American philosophy, and it's the essence of the California dream. Each year, an estimated 24,000 young undocumented students prepare to graduate from a California high school. Most of them are brought to this country at a very young age by their parents, and have been raised in the United States just as their U.S. citizen classmates. These children join their citizen friends in the community, in churches, in volunteer activities, and in high school graduations. These young scholars view themselves as Americans and are very loyal to our country. For most, the United States is the only country they know. Although many of these students were raised in California and are given residency tuition status, college is still financially unattainable for the majority of these low-income students who are ineligible to work because of their illegal status. The California DREAM Act would reduce the financial burden that AB 540 students face by allowing these students the ability to apply and receive financial aid in California. Specifically, AB 130 would allow students that meet the in-state tuition requirements to apply for and receive scholarships derived from non-state funds. I repeat, non-state funds. These are the state's most vulnerable students that have worked hard to exceed expectations. They've worked hard to achieve higher than average grade point averages and overcome many, many obstacles. These students, they're valedictorians, they're class presidents, they're all-star athletes, they're the future of California. Through their hard work and perseverance, these students have earned the opportunity to attend an institution of higher education. Their accomplishments should not be disregarded for their future jeopardizes, or their future jeopardized because of their legal status. This bill has no cost to the state, and I respectfully ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Debate or discussion? Senator Dutton.
Yeah, Mr. President and members, I'm actually more concerned about another one that's going to be coming up after this, but I will address my concerns regarding this program. It's not that the students that we're talking about are not necessarily hardworking and so forth, but what's happened here? Let me tell you what's actually happening in practice right now. as a result of AB 540, and this is linked to that, plus the other 130. See, my wife happens to be an instructor. She's a college, community college professor and career technical. And they've been having some problems with AB 540 application. You're going to have the same problem here. Here's what's happening. These young people that are signing up under these programs, see, they're not being given the full story. They don't realize that if you go into an X-ray technology program or something of that nature that requires some kind of a security clearance, that if you don't have your citizenship squared away before you graduate, you cannot get a license to practice in what you've been going to school for. See, that's what's not happening. And that's doing that's just doing an injustice to these young people. So while this is well-intended, it's not complete. And there are problems with the way the system is currently being applied. And that's going to be the same thing that will happen when we consider AB 131. That's the reason I would suggest a no vote on this. It's not fully cooked. It's not ready for prime time because it doesn't deal. These kids are going to be working hard. They're going to be going through the program. And they think that this is somehow gives them an automatic right to citizenship because nobody is helping them obtain any kind of a legal status, which is going to be required in order to get the license after they've worked hard in their pursuit of education. So I would suggest a no vote at this time and go to work on fixing the problems with this program.
Is there further debate or discussion? Senator Vargas.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Mr. President, I have the honor of sitting on the Senate Education Committee. A young woman, a very courageous young woman, came and spoke about what I would recall and talk about 2 days in Mexicali. That is this young lady, her mother went and to Mexicali for 2 days, and this young girl was born there, and her mother abandoned her. So she was abandoned in Mexicali for 2 days. Her grandmother then came and picked her up, brought her back to the United States. And this young lady grew up here in the United States thinking that she was an American citizen, worked hard, played by all the rules, and I wish she could have been there to see. I wish she could be here to speak, because I certainly can't do justice to what she said. But she talked about all the hardships in her life, all the real injustices that she faced and faced courageously and overcame, and then she finally got to the stage where she gets to college, the type of child that anyone would be proud to call his or her daughter. And she bumps up against the issue that she finds out she's undocumented. That's an injustice. That's the kind of injustice that God looks down and says, there's something wrong with that. We have a chance to do something today, and we ought to do it. I ask for your aye vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing, Senator De Leon on this item.
Thank you, Mr. President, as well as members. I have the distinct honor and pleasure to rise in support of this measure being jockeyed by our Vice Chair of the Latino Caucus, Senator Ron Calderon, and a great friend and a great leader in our community here, the author of this measure, Senator Gil Cedillo. For the last few decades, I would say that when we discuss the topic of immigration, it has been very politically charged, without question. I respect my colleagues' civility today. In the past, it has been very polarized and polemic. Each of us, I think, are quite well aware on the Senate floor that in some form or fashion, how we got to this country